It's a great day at Chappapila Sports Park. We are hosting tackle football here at Chappapila from ages 10 to 12 starting this fall. Registration is open now, and we've got some great local coaches that will be working with your student athletes. Scott Eister will be working with quarterbacks in the offense. Coach Junior Matthew will be helping me with the defense and some other local qualified coaches.
Today we are here in beautiful downtown Hammond with some amazing restaurateurs here in Hammond, Saul, Rubio, and we are here with Bryan, Wong. Thank you guys for joining us today.
Hey, thank you guys for having us too.
So we are so excited to be here and experience 113. I know it's been 3 years, but it's you guys have just done such an amazing job here.
Yes, we're actually 3 years in September. We're going to have our, of course, a very good event. We're going to close the parking lot. We'll really, I think this third year coming up, especially after COVID, we're able to do live events now. We have some really good stuff in store right now. I'm a part of the DDD board as well. We just got cleared to do live events in downtown Hammond. We have picnic at the park once a month.
That'll be awesome. And how perfect, you can come stop by 113, grab a drink, head out to the park.
Yes, of course. Of course, I want them to come to my restaurant, but you know, I do believe supporting every restaurant as well. So Sheena, a lot of the other restaurants do specials on the events of the picnic at the park. And of course, you know, the new restaurant right by, I think they renovated where the Pita Pit is right now. A Mule did. So of course, you know, that's open as well.
Opening this past week.
Yes. Of course, you know, one of the slogans, community over competition, you know, this community does well supporting everyone.
Which is something you have really lived by, both of you guys, supporting our local businesses and restaurants, even the ones that you're not a part of. And it's just so wonderful to see like the camaraderie that's a part of this area.
I think this guy right here has really taught me about that with, you know, it's not about just competing with other people. It's about competing with yourself as well, being better every day. And that's why I truly believe, you know, supporting everyone, you know, you want all the other restaurants, well, not just restaurants, all the other businesses to thrive in our downtown community.
Absolutely.
I love the community, you know, in Hammond, and I think one restaurant grows, everybody's gonna be better. And competition is always good to ourselves, I don't think with other business. And the more people we bring to downtown, the better for everybody. And we're working in a few different things to attract more people from every place around Hammond, and I think it's going to help a lot, everybody.
And that's right, you're actually working on some exciting renovations that's going to be happening at currently Street Side, but it's going to be coming up with a different name. And
now we're working on this restaurant, Street Side. The new name is going to be Soya, which means soy sauce, and soya is in Spanish, in Espanol. And we're working on a new different dishes, kind of tapas style, on Asian style. The restaurant is going to change a little bit on the inside. The outside is going to be new, mm-hmm. with a lot of seating, entertainment, and it's going to be wonderful.
That's awesome. Now, what made you guys come up with that name and concept? I'm guessing it's combining the two cultures together.
Combination between the two families, the Rubio and the Wongs. And I think the soy sauce is one of the most important ingredients on Asian food. I think the name has come up perfect. It's only four letters, easy to say.
Well, that's exciting. I can't wait to see it.
Yes, I think also Soya, you know, in this town, as Tran closed, of course, you know, which was my father and his brothers. I think reinventing it in a different way, especially going with the Saul as well, I think is going to be an exciting project in this town.
That is going to be so exciting. I mean, Trayan growing up is one of the classic favorites I know from anybody who's from Hammond. So it's exciting to see it grow and thrive and see all this awesome stuff happening. It's exciting.
Absolutely.
You know, the building, it has a life story too, where Soya is going to be. It's an old Ford dealership, and it's a beautiful building. It's one of the nicest buildings in downtown. The inside is beautiful. And now with the new additions inside the restaurant, it's going to be amazing, I think.
And I love that historical building has a really unique open floor plan that's really great to work with.
Well, it's really easy for people to to enjoy everybody just watching. And it's a social place. And I think it's perfect for the restaurant business. Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, some exciting stuff happening.
We're working on the style of the restaurant to make it more like a neighborhood style.
Yeah.
And when you can see your neighbors, your co-workers, everybody, your family, and everybody can talk to everybody. And I think that's a great thing for the community to do something like that.
Absolutely, especially after this last year we've had. Everybody wants to get out and be a part of the community and enjoy each other. And that's just such a perfect concept.
Everybody's ready to come to downtown and enjoy family, or friends, and everybody.
Yes. Okay, so we're here inside the beautiful building of 113, and I have to say, every time I'm coming here, it amazes me that this actually used to be a doctor's office.
Yes, Sam. So this used to be a John Desmond building, famous architect in Hammond, did a lot of the southeastern buildings, LSU rec. I don't know if y'all noticed the Sims Library at Southeastern with the big windows, very unique architect. But it also is a historic building, so as you could tell, when we go to the patio later, like, my whole life, that was grass back in the day. You know, I used to walk my dog there my whole life. So it is so cool that we could finally turn this into a restaurant.
Which it's awesome. And I know, being from Hammond, you can see that. I love that you guys were able to still keep that small town feel in here. But also, when you come to 113, you don't feel like you're in a small town. You feel like you're in the city.
It's yes. Very unique concept. You know, of course, if you come in here, it's a little loud. But, you know, I do believe in fine dining. But I don't like it completely quiet all the time. So, you know, creating a different live atmosphere was totally different in Hammond, which makes it very special and unique.
It absolutely is, and gorgeous atmosphere. Love it. So I'm actually here today with your general manager as well, Kyle.
Yes.
Thank you for joining us. So I know I got to take a sip of that delicious drink. I just want to show it real quick because this is so pretty. The passion fruit. This is the passion fruit.
Passion fruit martini. Yes.
Passion fruit martini. And guys, you have to try this. It is absolutely amazing. But I know y'all actually have drink specials going on tonight on Thursdays, right?
Yes, we have a Thirsty Thursday. Usually we have a drink special that runs from Tuesday all the way to Sunday. On Tuesday, we have the Teeny Tuesday. We have passion fruit martini. That's one of our featured ones. On Wednesday, we have Wine Down Wednesday, so, which is like a Norma Jean Merlot. We have a La Torta Moscato. So we kind of have a red and a white, you know, kind of blend. Half off bottles on that day.
Half off of the bottles on Wednesdays.
Well, specialty bottles. Not every bottle, but we do have specialty bottles that we have half off. And then on Thursday, you know, we have a, you know, we have $3 beers, $4 wells, you know, $5 champagne, $6 glasses of wine, $7 specialty cocktails, which is also that passion fruit martini too as well. So and then on Sunday we have $6 mimosas and then $15 bottlemen. So we try to hit every kind of clientele, get everybody in here. It's a privilege to be here, privilege to work here, and privilege to serve the community
That's
too
awesome.
As well.
And I love all the deals and the specials you're talking about. A lot of people will have a misconception when you pass by such a wonderful, nice restaurant like this. Oh, I can't afford to go in there. But there's these deals that you can come in every day and be able to enjoy something.
Yes, ma'am.
Reasonably priced.
Also, and we have also an appetizer menu. Some of those price points are really good for, like, you know, college crowds that come in. They get a cocktail, or they get a beer, or they get a martini, some crab cakes, some honey corn shrimp. Have a good time, you know, feel at home. You know?
Absolutely, yes. Now, I know one of my favorite meals to enjoy here is your brunch specials on Saturday and Sundays.
Yes. Well, I'm not going to lie. I like the classic breakfast. I'm a classic breakfast fan. We have an awesome classic breakfast here, too, as well. We have a crab cake Benedict, bacon Benedict. So, you know, we just kind of hit all those markets. We have a lot of, you know, seafood and stuff like that on the menu, you know, to cater to everybody.
Yeah.
Yes. So, right now, you know, we have our filet and we have our honey pecan shrimp. I just want to tell a short story on what makes our food unique and the techniques that we cook in this restaurant. So we do cook on all wood-burning grills. You know, short story, me and my father, when I was younger, we always used to love cooking in the backyard, you know, starting the fire, cooking our steaks on there, getting that really good flavor. So I think serving it on these hot stones is very unique as well.
Adding that extra delicious flavor with the wood burning.
Yes, ma'am. And what we have right here is a classic dish from actually Tran, from my father. And funny story on this one, me and my dad were on Guy's Grocery Games, and we actually lost on this dish, but it was actually my fault. But this is our spin on our honey pecan shrimp, which, you know, of course, we did a different version of the sauce and is served with honey sriracha as well. So
all of our steaks come accompanied with these sauces. So we have a chimichurri, we have a romesco, we have an herb butter sauce too as well. Also with a green onion on top, kind of gives the flavor the dish more eye-popping, you know.
Yeah.
We like a lot of green, you know, here. We love our greens here. But as far as that, like I was telling you also about the cocktails and about the Wine Wednesday, a lot of people come here and they get the 100-pound shrimp to accompany that too as well.
Hey, Ryan, well, thank you so much for having us today. The food and the drinks, everything was just phenomenal.
Hey, thank y'all so much for coming anytime.
Absolutely. Can you remind everybody your hours of operation for 113?
Yes, and I know our hours have been confusing this past year. It's been a wild year with COVID and everything, but we're open now. So it's gonna be we are open from Tuesday through Sunday, and we're for the daytimes, we're open Thursday through Sundays.
Okay, awesome.
Yes.
Well, be sure to stop by, especially for brunch on the weekends, and show 113 some local love.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm the African-American Honorary Service Award recipient, Samuel Eccles, and I'm inviting you to a month of excitement this summer at the Tangipahoa Parish Library in July. The Calfee Puppets, Animal Tales, and Miss Kim's Petting Zoo are always a crowd favorite. For more information, visit tangilibrary.com. I'll see you this summer at the library.